All right. Hello and welcome back to, this is The Police. Yeah, I've been absent for, like, the past 2 days. We've been having some very odd, like, storms around Pennsylvania, and, like, 2 days ago, my power cut out multiple times, and I figured it wasn't worth trying to stream during that time, because I only get about, like, 20 or so minutes of playing, and then power outage. So, that. Then I went to a party, and hey, Cyril, how's it going? Then yesterday I went to a party, and even if I had streamed that day, there's power outages again. However, yesterday, it was my neighbor's, birthday, so I went over to my neighbor's house and he had, like, some giant seafood thing. It was friggin' awesome. But it coincided with the same day that the local, carnival, or I guess town fair, I guess you could call it, had a fireworks display. But what was so fucking cool about it was a fireworks display during a lightning storm. Like, basically they rushed the, normally it would have happened probably around 10 o'clock or something, but they rushed it thinking, we'll beat the storm. And there was freaking giant bolts of, like, lightning that would last, like, at least, like, half of a second, which if you think about it, is like a few pulses of lightning, with fireworks. It was probably one of the most badass things I've ever seen in my life. So very happy to see that. But yeah, let's continue. I don't know where we left off in this The Police exactly. But I remember we have to read these. I think we... Oh, yeah! So last time, we actually went back a week and a half because we had picked the incorrect frames for the serial murderer, the dentist. And basically, the penalty for not picking the right frames is essentially you lose 80% of your salary, your current bank account, and 80% of your employees. So I was like, no, fuck that. I'm going back a week and a half just so that I can get this right, because that is a hell of a penalty. So we went back in time and basically got rewarded $125,000 for catching the right guy. Although it played out the same way that we got basically given the 6-foot-tall woman who committed the murders, but, like, she was obviously told to do so. But anyway, let's continue. Let's see, Modern Art Gallery opens Modern Paint course. Disabled Society demands increased benefits. Probably gonna have to suppress a riot or something, I don't know. And by suppress, I mean just go there to have presence and then be like, no, this is actually a peaceful thing, and then retreat. And let's see, bride suffers happiness heart attack at city registry office. Alright, and how are we doing here? Alright, we have to do one more bullshit task for City Hall. Let's do it. Alright, I'm too tired, I can hardly work straight, can I go home? Yeah, actually, he is pretty tired. Yeah, go home. Go home. I think we literally just hired that guy too, so great, you know, great way to, like, really, you know, give me a reason to keep you on the force. Let's see here. I don't think I've listened to this. I don't remember that, cassette. Interesting. But yeah, look at that, 300,000. Oh, yeah! So we came up to this weird thing yesterday where I solved the hit-and-run case, or the hit-and-run investigation. It's been quite a long time since I've solved any other investigations, and it just so happens that it's Henry Sand, who's, like, one of the main, officers of, Mr. Sand's mafia. I kind of don't want to respond to it at all, but I don't know if, like, I might have to, because Mole just might be stuck being the lead investigator in this. And I don't think I can remove her or do anything. Because if I go to investigations, the only thing I can do is arrest the suspect, and I can't, like, remove her. And I'm pretty sure if I opened up something else today, I wouldn't be able to do it anyway. So let's, like, reopen the theft case and see. Okay, so we can get Beasley Moser home. Alright, let's put these guys here just so they can work on something today. What I'm gonna try to do is maybe switch her lead to something else and then never respond to that. Because I feel like once I respond to that call, basically Mr. Sand's gonna be like, what the hell, Jack? Freaking A. Alright, two garbage men were emptying. Oh yeah, so we did do some of these on Friday, but then the power cut out. So I know some of these, but I'll read them again. Two garbage men were emptying some cans near bus stop. A drunk man came past and thought he'd make fun of them. He tried to make them fight him, so the garbage men got angry and stuffed him in a can and threw him in the garbage truck. Then they continued on their route. Alright, Kaloon and Chin, go for it. Sweet. Anything with, like... Nah, two more days till I can request some stuff. I've been pretty good with requests recently, too, which is very nice. Alright. Cool. Excellent. Now, I'm wondering, we have, like, these affairs right now. I'm wondering what these would be. Like, I want, if I went Vargas, would I have, like, a Vargas tab down here? Like, there's all these other tabs. I wonder if, what's gonna be in there, if anything. Hey, friggin' 300,000 there. Desire Park. Two old men were sitting on a park bench playing chess. Suddenly, one of them, dashed the pieces of the board, grabbed it, and started beating his opponent in the head with it. The eyewitnesses called in quite agitated hurry. The old man's whole head is covered in blood. Okay. Vendal Hatton, go for it. Holy crap. Well, that's savage. Friggin' A. What we got? The police caught up with the garbage truck and pulled over. Two men in overalls were laughing in the cab. The joke's over. Released a hostage. And then the drunk man gets in the garbage truck, shakes the dirt off, and attacks the police. And here's the real beast. Scavengers, bastards. You're the worst of all. Filling your bellies at our expense. You should all die. Throw him back into the garbage truck. Nice. I love that. I love some of the options you get in this game, and some of them, like, as ridiculous as they sound, actually work. Alright, the report on the assault. Good. Wonderful. Excellent. Sweet. Let's see, bomb threat. An elderly employee at Scissor Sisters, an office supply store, reported a courier brought in a suspicious parcel. The civilian crushed in the garbage. I mean, I don't think they actually did the compacting thing. Or at least I hope they didn't. I'm pretty sure if they didn't, if they did do the trash compactor, we would probably have, like, a dead civilian on our hands. So I'm pretty sure we did okay there. Or it's one of those, you know, don't ask any questions sort of deal. We'll have to see. Anywho, let's see. The return address is smeared with ketchup or blood. And hey, the smells, how's it going? Scissor Sisters. I know, right? That one, too. Let me see. No one else can hear it, but I swear I can hear something in ticking inside. That is a name right there. Oh, shit. Yeah, you're right. Can I send three over? All right. I want to save at least, like, two people, usually. Oh, my. All right. I really enjoy, like, some of the, like, different things that pop up. They're great. A young female pharmacist said an addict of with a length of steel pipe is trying to break into her pharmacy. Oh, shit. Yeah, let's not let that go. I mean, how many police officers weren't? See, bomb threat. Inside was a large box of staples. And I am for a turn from an unhappy customer. How can you be unhappy with the state of your staples? Like, staples are staples. You can't really, like, not... That's weird. Yeah, it's been raining all day. Oh, for where you are. Yeah. It's gonna rain here eventually, so we might end up with the whole, like, stream cut out early because of storms, because for some reason Pennsylvania's just been getting, like, battered by crazy storms. Let's see. An old man called in a report right in front of his favorite park bench. A group of crazy-looking people wearing very revealing clothing were flopping around in the glass, spitting on the feelings of God-fearing Christians and alarming everybody. What? I mean, I don't think this is probably someone overreacting, but wait. A group of crazy-looking people wearing very revealing clothing were flopping around on the grass, spitting on the... Okay, so there's a bunch of people. It's probably a theater troupe. You're probably right. I'll send people to it anyway and then regret it. As it always works. Oh, gosh. An addict has broken a window and he's trying to climb through. His feet are still sticking out. By the way, for anybody, you know, who's thinking, I'm gonna, you know, crash into a glass thing, you gotta understand that there's gravity. I'm pretty sure if we try to drag him back through, we'd end up slicing him in half, because that's how glass works. I think I remember the episode before this, I mentioned how in some action movies, you'll see people, like, wrap their hand in, like some sort of cloth and then punch a mirror out that way, or not a mirror, glass, to protect their hand. But you do have to be careful to go straight in, because if you go a little bit up, a little bit down, you hit the other glass, and that is super sharp. So I'm pretty sure, like, if we actually pulled the man out, we'd risk injuring him. Remove the addict's sneakers and tickle his feet. The addict falls out of the window and back on the street. He drops the scrap of pipe and tries to escape. Flirt with the pharmacist! What? Oh my gosh. You know, I've never used pepper spray before. Sweet. Sweet. And nice. Beard's 1,000. He's probably our best cop right now. Shit, yeah. What do we got? Disorderly conduct? Elderly man was outraged at a yoga group, which had decided to hold a masterclass in the park. All these young people in skin-tight clothing are flopping about in the park. It's disgusting. Like some sort of nudist fish. Let's see. Kimberly Adams was celebrating her birthday with some friends and acquaintances. After a long dinner, she started opening her gifts and found a huge dildo. She flushed and then grabbed the sex toy. Wait, she flushed? She flushed and then grabbed the sex toy and attacked her friend who gave her the gag present. You bitch, you soulless monster. All my friends from the seminary are here. Is that what you want them to think of me? Miss Adams then continued to beat her friend over the head until she's made a bloody mess of her scalp. With the dildo? Do we really need to send 3 people? Yeah, flushing as in blushing. Yeah, that's what I thought. Let's see. What is this? Once again, I could really use her help. I'm trying to expand the ranch, but the adjacent territory belongs to, fucking idiots who are asking an insane amount for it. Today I'll be their regular meeting with them. I want a bunch of police officers to come in during the meeting and, start asking, lots of questions about murders on the property, maniacs, running loose, drug addicts living nearby, stuff like that. Basically, help me, but pressure the, sellers and knock the costs down a little bit. Yeah, no, that's like some, like, shifty shit. Hey, the power, how's it going? Yeah, the power? Yeah, there's a woman being assaulted with a dildo. So, you know, that's just fairly typical, right? Yeah. It was supposed to be a gag present. Wink. But, you know, she didn't take kindly to it. So let's see. Theodore Deramus, caretaker and of the candy factory, reports that 5 masked men broke into the door and disappeared inside. The watchman wanted to do his duty and intervene, but there are too many of them. It wouldn't be smart. They'd just nail me to the wall. You better come sort this out yourselves. Interesting. It's true. It's true. Let's see here. Let's definitely bring, like, Robbins, Hatton, and Calhoun, maybe? I feel like it's a three-cop job. A gag present. What do we got here? A noise complaint. Angry man just phoned in, yelling about his neighbors. He's been hearing terrible ringing and shouting coming from every side of the house. My ears are going to explode. You have to stop them right away. He's probably got his hearing aid cranked up too high or something. Whoa! That's some blood. The girl is pounding her friend's head with all her might. Her victim hasn't been conscious for a while. The huge crowd is gathering around. It's impossible to get near the fight. Blow the police whistle with all your might. Might as well. That's the dildo. Seeing the police, the assailant comes to her senses. Jumps back and makes a break for the door, pushing people out of the way with her sex toy. Arm the taser, let's see. Run to the victim who's waking up and groaning, and begin giving her mouth to mouth. That's a pretty big dildo. that's quite something. It's a hell of a slap. Let me see. I say we arm the taser and run after the girl. There we go. Taser's usually a safe bet. I mean, also, let's just put this in perspective. How hard must that dildo have been, right? Like, that's a tough dildo to actually beat someone in the head enough to make them bleed. Either that, or she's just so damn angry that she's flinging around this floppy dildo until, like, she finally caused some damage, which you'd think someone would have intervened at some point, you know, it taking, like, basically 10 minutes to actually cause some sort of damage to someone. They make some... I guess you're right. Let's see. Mrs. Kent called in to complain about a drunken neighbor who decided it would be fun to go after sundown and shoot the beer cans in his backyard. Get that drunk behind bars before he kills someone. Oh my gosh. Let's see. Former psychiatric patient who recently stopped taking his prescribed medication. Gotcha. Mm-hmm. This is 1985. The best you could have is a camcorder. And I guess, I don't know, sell it to a less reputable news station, I guess, would be the equivalent to making it viral on YouTube in 1985. High military grade polymer dildo. Oh my. That might be a little bit too intense. Can we be fine with three people in SWAT? I'm thinking so. Oh, dude, I hate when that happens, Creeper. I hate when that happens. Aw, man, no new frames found. Damn it. Oh my gosh, Power. But yeah, it's a shame there's really no good locational thing for Pokemon Go right now. What? You're kidding me. Wow. Wow. That drunk guy killed two of my guys. That sucks. Wow. Yeah, we're gonna declare both of them dead. That way I can hire more people, but hot damn, I was not prepared for that. Jeez. Oh gosh, Power. Alright, theater director, we need to, fresh faces and new voices. Let's see. Drug addiction in the city increased by 30%, and Freiburg Chess Master reaches World Cup. Nice. Hey, City Hall actually really likes us. Oh gosh, Creeper. This is a Pokemon robbery. There's an Ivysaur in your house and I have to catch it. Oh gosh! Take the Ivysaur, please!
Mr. Boy, this is for you.
Alright, let's see what's going on.
That's it?
What's it?
This is from our guy.
What?
It's from the private detective.
What? Oh, no. No, Mr. Boyd. It's from an Agent Dixon.
Fine. I'm sorry I couldn't swing by before I left, but I'll definitely be back to celebrate your retirement, Ethan.
All the Dratini's
Bobby back. Flash, Diamonds and Thieves. Bobby Flash and the Card Shop. Bobby Flash and the Cats Club. Bobby Flash and the Temptations. Ah, that's what I need.
All right. But yeah, if you're unfamiliar, this game is called This is the Police. It's a... I'd call it, like, a narrative police chief simulator. Basically, you play Jack Boyd, that guy that we just saw in that cinematic. And, essentially, I think it is the power. I think it is PC exclusive for the time being. Seeing as how the engine looks pretty simple, I'd think it would be okay to transfer to different consoles and whatnot, but I haven't heard about that yet. But yeah, it's a cool game. It's very, you know, it's a text-based thing, it's managing different stuff, and you know, you're in the game literally dealing with life and death, so it's pretty severe sometimes. Alright, let's resume. Alright, so let's start the new day. Oh yeah, I keep forgetting to put more things on. What's this? Alright, let's listen to that. Sweet. What is this? Mr. Boyd, I'm Ron Actus. We haven't yet had the pleasure, but I'm sure you passed by my lovely skyscraper from time to time. It's a wonderful building, and I'd like to expand the surrounding territory. I've received all the necessary documents from the demolition of a small neighborhood park. The crew is standing by, but as always, the rabble are causing lots of problems. Ladies with strollers and dog lovers claiming they use the park every day. I wouldn't want you to take me in for accidentally burying one of the protesters under any concrete. Well, shit. If you can send some men to break up those bums, I'd be extremely grateful. Interesting. No, I know, right? I guess we're gonna send. Good gravy, that's everybody I have. I can always restart the day. This is a very early day occurrence, so we could probably get away with it. Alright, and we can hire two more people from the labor market because I've had people die on me. Let's see. Alright, let's get Donna Fitzsimmons for what? Shift A? And we'll also need, let's go, Tygo in A, shift A. Cool. Let's see here. I think that's about it. Now let me see investigations. Now, I can arrest the suspect today, but I'm kind of afraid of that. Why don't we open up the drug sales? Okay, so I have to. I actually have to. Alright, so... I'll have to wait till people get back, but I'll go for that eventually. What do we got here? Let's see. A lunatic named Dorothy Townsend snuck out of her room again and broke into the seclusion area we have for violent criminals. She had hoped to escape with her husband, who was also a patient. This is the report we received from Carl Carter, a doctor at the psychiatric hospital. The woman has raised a fuss among the other patients there. The nurses are being beaten while the hospital is wrecked. They've locked themselves in and they're driving each other wild. Several nurses have barricaded themselves inside, but we have to get to them soon. Please hurry. Oh gosh. Well, just as I thought, Mr. Boyd, we make a great team. With my resources and your abilities, we could work wonders together. I'll be glad to provide you with any services I can for modest fee. It's the least I can do. Wow, 12,000, damn. No, it's all right, Creeper. I'll check that out later. Awesome. There we go. So it looks like I've, you know, pretty much just freaking ignored everybody here. Let's see, breaking and entering. So. Aha! So I was wondering when other stuff would open up. So what do we got here? We can... So I definitely had to respond to that, because... otherwise I wouldn't have this option, I'm pretty sure. Actually, you know what? The day's so early. Was there any time limit to that? You know what? Let's restart the day. Load. Yeah. Let's restart the day, because I'm not sure if there was a thing on there. Yep, okay. Cool. Also to hire another snitch. Alright, and we saw
Mr.
this.
Mr. Boyd, this is for you.
Because it could be that that has no time limit, and we could just send someone right at the end of the day. I think I forgot to feed my fish back at the house. Can I have the day off? No. Fish can survive one day without being fed. I have like 14 goldfish. I would know. Sometimes you feed them too much, and that's a big problem. Actually, I have a really chubby goldfish. I named him Chubby. So that has no time limit. Okay, so I could definitely be spending my time a little better there. Alright, hire for shift A, and hire for shift A. Alright, so, when we have time we'll do that, but we'll just sort of wait. But yeah, so that'll be another thing we can use. Alright, breaking and entering. Let's see, we're probably gonna want some high-level people, some low-level people. Let's go with that. See how that goes. All right. What do we have here? We have a firefight. Witness says that a dark sedan abruptly stopped in the middle of the street. A man with a pistol jumped out and began firing through the window of a restaurant. The caller thought it seemed like someone was firing back, but he wasn't sure. All right. And SWAT, proceed. I love how, like, the insane asylum is literally on an island. I love that. It's like some weird sort of Alcatraz situation. Alright, awesome. Once these guys come back, I'll send two officers to help arrest that guy. Ooh, we have an abduction. Refuse? Hey, Phantom, how's it going? We're okay, good. Whoops. We have an abduction. Alright, let's put, as we normally do, two people, get it, and then get it out. Okay. I'm doing good, doing good. Nice, Creeper, nice. Alright, so let's get this hit and run then. Let's do Hunter and Kochi. And I don't think we need SWAT for this. Hopefully. Alright, what do we got here? An attempted robbery. A teller noticed three hooded men enter the bank carrying sport bags. The frightened teller whispered in the phone, "Hurry up, I think they're going to rob us. Why else would they be carrying those bags?" I'll send three. How many fish? I think it's more like 15. We have an abduction, which basically we immediately just go like this and archive it so that I can have more resources later. And let's see. Jack, you got into our business when you opened an investigation regarding the abduction. It would be better for the both of us if the thing is settled by 4:05. Now, they're making a large withdrawal. I know, right? Yeah, Phantom, yeah. Actually, it's been crazy recently. Like, legit, today we might actually, like, just have my stream go down because of storms again. It's pretty wild. I don't know what's been going on recently, but we've had nasty storms. Now, last time I've had this Mafia assignment dealing with an investigation, I archived it, and then, it's really weird. What we got here? We got a fraud. What's over here? An imprisonment. Let's go with these guys. Let's see what's going on. Evelyn Farrell, Mr. Flight, because she mixed up travel dates. Her contract with Top Adventures clearly stated that the payment could be reimbursed only if the customer canceled the trip in advance, not a month after the fact. Alright, let's proceed, I suppose. And hit and run. Excellent. It's true, yeah, it's true. Technically, it's not raining right now, but I've heard that it's going to be pretty bad. Nice, case closed. Oh no, I won't be able to get that one. Armed robbery. The men had returned from the gym and were stopping into the bank to take out some cash. Nice. Nice. Way to waste my time, lady. Damn, people are actually going to die. I didn't even read that imprisonment thing. Probably it was something horrible. You did know it, Creeper. You knew it. You knew it. Alright, let's see what's going on here. Assault at the Magpie Publishing House. Senior writer Ivan Brukhov attacked a young editor who was reading his manuscript. The madman tried to strangulate him. Interesting. Alright. Go for it. The fraud report. Evelyn Farrell, Mr. Flight, because she mixed up the travel dates. Her contract with Top Adventures clearly stated that the payments could be reimbursed only if the customer canceled the trip in advance, not a month after the fact. Oh, okay. What we got here? Public indecency. Several witnesses reported that a naked man is riding a motorcycle through the city. He's carrying a pistol and shooting it into the air while he laughs hysterically. He is very wild and dangerous. He almost knocked over a girl who was crossing the road. Then he took aim at her and tried to shoot her. Okay. Holy crap. Let's look at our investigations again now. Does he want me to solve the case? Is that what he's saying? Oh, come on, are you fucking kidding me, Christopher Sand? Jeez. I can never understand what he wants me to do. Hey, Lady Serenia, how's it going? I can send Samandi. Cool with that? Oh, yeah, Phantom, oh gosh. What do you mean by that? I was having some issues with power. But, you know, that could also happen again today. I never understand what Mr. Sand actually wants. It would be awesome if it clearly said, I want you to archive this and never touch it again. I don't freaking know. Let's see. Bykov is sitting in the top, on top of the editor, strangling him. Now, I think we've learned from this that artists love talking about their work and will totally drop everything they're doing. So we're going to just ask him, Mr. Bykov, I have a question about one of your novels. At the end of the Holy Rainbow, why does Blavmov sell his house? Yes. Yeah, Lady Serenia. So that was an issue. We had a terrible lightning storm that happened on Friday. And so I tried to start it. It cut out. And then I tried to start it again. And then, like, it was just a lot of power surges. Which could happen again today if we're not lucky. But we'll try and see if we can stick through it. It shouldn't... I mean, it's not starting yet, so we might be lucky, but we'll see. The pizza delivery man picked up an order in the morning and didn't return for the rest of the day. The manager said their couriers had been attacked and robbed a few times, and they were very worried about the young man. The missing person is Robert Derry, who is known for his carelessness. He also nearly been fired for absenteeism. Yeah, Saber of Stream today. Yeah, I hosted that shit. It was great. Let's see. Public indecency. Excellent. Mario, Aaron, you can whisper me the link and I'll take a look at it later. Yeah, Creeper, alright. I don't have anybody right now. Let's see, the Tipsy Bar visitor, this is at Kevin's Throat Bar. Tipsy Bar, visitor, reported that a bartender tried to sell him a gun. Basically, I was just sitting there drinking and complaining about my wife, who's insisting on a divorce. Bitch threatened to take away my children, says I'm drunk bastard and I don't appreciate her. So I tell all this to the bartender, and he listens and he nods. And then he said, my friend, you've got to teach that bitch a lesson, come on, I've got exactly what you need in the back. So basically, I followed him, and he's got a box with a bunch of guns. Pick one, he says, give it to you dirt cheap. But I just said, I'll think about it, and then I gave you guys a call. Oh my gosh, that's friggin' nuts. Oh my gosh. As a silly Charizard dance. Although, I opened that wrong, so I have to go back and open chat again. Whoops. Let's see here. How in the world... There we go, now it's back. Excellent. Alright, so... Can't go to that quite yet. I don't have enough people. Actually, I will have four people almost immediately now. Alright, let's have SWAT. And... Yeah, let's do that. Mr. Derry met some girls at the beach and decided to stay and party with them. False alarm. That's true, Mario. That's very true. When you have a bad wife problem, you need to call SWAT. You know what, Lady Serenia? I've tried for 2 days to get No Man's Sky working, and it crashes as soon as I start it. There's some issues. I think it has to deal with incompatibilities with certain drivers right now. But yeah, I can't play No Man's Sky. Because it crashes on startup. So, they said that they'd be coming up with a fixing patch earlier next week. So we'll have to see. Alright, so I can't go to it right now. Abduction report. Okay. I know, it stinks. I hope we get reimbursed somehow for the fact that it was supposed to come out, like, what, 2 days ago and be playable, right? Oh, jeez, what are you gonna do? Oh, I can't go to it yet. What do we got here? The bar is crowded and smoky, and there's a skinny guy lying on the floor. The bartender is wiping the counter with a dirty rag. Yeah, something like that. Let's see. Bar's crowded and smoky, and there's a skinny guy lying on the floor. The bartender is wiping the counter with a dirty rag. That could be a completely unrelated thing. So I'm going to say... Everybody finish your drinks and get out. The bartender drops his rag and puts his hands under the bar. The skinny guy on the floor starts to vomit. Keep your hands where I can see them. Nice. It's true, Mario Aaron, true. It killed the game's frame rate. I know. It's so sad. I mean, don't get me wrong. I'm going to play No Man's Sky when eventually the patch comes out that allows me to play it. Which is fine. Well, it's not fine, but at the same time, like, you know, I'll wait. But yeah, it kind of stinks that, you know, I prepaid $60 for a game that I still can't play. And I'm hoping that at some point they'll have some sort of way to basically reimburse people that are, looking for that, you know, to play the game. Maybe something like a oh no! I wasn't able to get it. Is it going to come back tomorrow? Damn, we just had a busy day today. Shit. Maybe we should have responded to that first. Arrest the vomiting man! Oh, gosh. Well, I think, it's only 15 people working on No Man's Sky, right? I think here's the main issue, and I don't mean to start console stuff, but at the same time, it seems as if that because they launched No Man's Sky on PS4 first, they made a port from PS4 to PC, and of course it's not going to work. Like, I'm just gonna say it right now. Of course it's not going to work. Let's see here. Let's see. Bigfoot Athletic Shoe Store began charity marathon. Okay. Expert Municipal, public toilets need major repairs. A number of buses increased on all routes. I mean, some of it, yes, Creeper, but not all of it. Let's see. He didn't come to work today. Oh, awesome. I was hoping that. Alright. You know what? Platonic has actually done some good stuff for us. Good job. Oh, no, totally. No, totally. If I was the developer of No Man's Sky, if there was something wrong and, like, there was just the inkling of incompatibility with certain, like, computer video cards and whatnot, I would have totally delayed it and apologized, as opposed to releasing it and then basically everybody going, "What the fuck is this?" Because that's probably the worst thing you could possibly do. But then again, you know, indie stuff, so what are you going to do? They're learning all this now. But they probably won't make the same mistake twice now. Hopefully. Oh my gosh, Mario. Yeah. I mean, this is in... Whoa. Henry Sand turned out to be a member of the gang known as Sands. He shall be take down the gang if you want to make him an informant. Refuse. No, no, hell no. Oh, good. I can go back to this. Wonderful. Oh, yeah. I want everything. What do we got here? Armed robbery. Oh, gosh, that guy not coming to work really busts my balls. Gotcha. There's a Weedle! I know, my town's basically, it's all Weedles and Pidgeys. It's kind of ridiculous. Four men flagged down a truck outside the diner and then pulled the truck driver out of the cab. The diner's cook called in. Now they're searching the truck and one of the men is carrying an axe. Holy shit. All right. Jeez. Oh, gosh. Is that the Charizard you found, Mario? Nice. Nice. Extortion. We have received a complaint about some students who say their new physical education teacher is extorting money from them for grades. Yeah, we can't have that. I mean, it's true. It's very true. One, I don't know. I can't, in my experience, I don't know, I haven't come across a game yet that hasn't had a bug to it. Now granted, I'm like one of those people who, if there's a bug in a game, I'll find it. Oh gosh, what is going on? Oh no, I love Bethesda games, but yeah, there's some bugs there. Alright, I'll have to take a look at that later, Creeper. Let's see. Alright, let's see here. The police arrived at a gym during recess. The gym teacher spots them and tries to escape, but the other exit is chained shut. So the windows are and the windows are secured with a thick steel screen. Let me see. Let's do the calm down. We just want to talk. In panic, the teacher quickly climbs up the rope to the ceiling of the gym. I can wait, my shift just started. Yes. Oh no, totally. I think what it comes down to is basically video games are becoming so more complex nowadays. It's kind of impossible to like not have bugs almost because there's so much going on. Oh my gosh. Jack, we have something going down today at 2100. We wouldn't want any policemen crashing the party. I think 3000 should be enough for such a request. We're fine. An armed robbery report. Good. Offender caught. Officers unharmed. Civilians unharmed. Wonderful. Alright, now, unfortunately, there's a lot of shit going on at the same time. Unlawful assembly. Let's see. Drivers gathered at City Hall parking lot protesting against their recent increase in vehicle tax. According to one of the eyewitnesses, they set fire to several tires, but otherwise they're behaving fairly well. What? Okay, what do we have here? We have an assault. An elderly homeless man was found urinating on the wall of the cathedral. One of the parishioners who found him grew furious. He threw the old man to the ground and beat the bottoms of his feet, shouting, "You're an animal. You don't deserve to walk on this earth." And suspicious individual. Alright, if everybody gets back soon, I could take care of some of these things. Oh my gosh, why are there so many things going on? Alright, let's get the assault. When everybody else gets back... How big is this unlawful assembly? Oh, that's a lot of people. We could send two people there and then see what we can spare. Let's check this out. Let's see. A man called an emergency whispering hysterically. He said that he's sitting in the kitchen and Mephistopheles is coming over for a drink. It's the goddamn devil. Come get him. Okay, well, you're crazy. Alright, unlawful assembly. Let's go to that. Just send in... Beard can handle it! The drunk man confused his regular drinking companion with the devil. Oh shit, what is this one? Armed robbery. Damn it, I always miss the armed robberies. Tony Bingham, broker, spoke quickly on the phone. I just brushed up against some asshole in a blue cap out on the street. He came up behind me, jabbed me in the back with a gun, and took my wallet, my watch, and my gold ring. While I was looking for a payphone to call the police, I saw him again. He's 10 yards away. I'm looking at him. I'm looking right at him. Interesting. That'd be badass if he could be like, "All right, Beard, you're going on this, but we are equipping you with the shotgun." Like, that'd be so awesome. All right, Chero. Join the detectives for this one. I need you. No! City Hall! If only I had that one extra person! An official from the mayor's office will be visiting the bookstore today, present his biography, The Great Big Man's Business. It is necessary to ensure his safety. I'm sorry, I can't. If you'd only give me time to respond. Yep, it was actually real. And that dude was killed. Okay. Let's see, for the assault. Okay. And I'm gonna refuse. Take care of it. Yeah, they did fine. It's Beards with them. Yeah, Mario Iron. Alright. Creeper. Oh man, that'd be hilarious. I would love that. Oh, I couldn't get it in time. The actual culprits were a couple of stray dogs. Okay, it was a false alarm regardless. Now, if I was to... Oh gosh, that's like my whole entire team gone. Alright, I'll wait till there's like a last second thing. Ooh, what do we got here? Oh, this is... what's the thing I'm supposed to ignore? No, that's a 2100. Okay. Let's see. Enraged by the latest wave of cuts at the plant, Adair Oritz attacked his boss and beat him severely. His co-workers were afraid Mr. Oritz has really snapped and called the police. One husky ironworker said this, "We always had problems with Ada. He gets angry a lot. Or maybe Ada? I'm not sure. But this time it's different. His eyes are bloodshot. He's growling like a wild beast and he's about to throw the boss into a vat of molten metal." Oh gosh. Hey Zay Zay, how's it going? Let's see. I guess we're gonna send everybody we got, except maybe two people? Something like that. I don't know, Mario, but if I had a Charizard dancing like that, I feel like he might be effective in gyms. Oh, thanks for the follow, Mario Aaron. Thank you. But yeah, it might be the most effective thing at a gym, right? Because who would want to remove that from a gym, right? Oh yes, and I'm supposed to ignore that one. Let's see, Adir Oritz is standing near a vat of molten metal. He's wearing a protective suit and holding his unconscious boss by the throat, screaming like a wild man. This is a tough one. I feel like we gotta push them away from the vat first. Because right now, I feel like if you shoot the suspect, he might let the man go and fall off the edge. And same thing with the other thing, is he might scare him and let the unconscious, his unconscious boss fall into the vat of molten metal. Alright, good. That was the good, right decision there. Wonderful. All right, what time is it? Oh, it's almost time for Morwen. I know, it's so sad. It's sad. All right, what do we have here? Oh, shit. We received an anonymous tip from a local car dealership is being used to smuggle heroin. According to the anonymous source, the drugs are hidden in the spare tire you'll see. You know what? Let's say screw that, and I'm gonna have everybody go this one. Theft report? Really? You four guys are working on this, and you cannot find... Oh my gosh, what? Wait a second, what if it's a two-person job? What if it's a two-person job? Alright, let me think here. So, what if it's... He's the guy who picks up the drugs. He's the one who breaks in and takes it. See, those look like the empty cabinets. No? Damn it, still got nothing there. Wait, what are you saying? No change, order of the... Oh, change the order of the doctor. Okay, thank you. Now let's take a look. Details. I've been having a hard time with this one. I haven't solved it in a long time. So, is it like, shut the lights off first, then open the door? He turns off the lights first. And I guess he goes in, or turns off the light, maybe he grabs a bag first, then opens the, aha, there we go, okay, gotcha. Colin Marcus, hospital head physician. Thank you, Zay Zay, thank you. That was great. Do what voice? What the cephalopod said. That thing you're talking about? Oh gosh, what happened here? Everybody's busy right now. What's this? Oh, I have to choose where to go. Oh, and thank you for from Mr. Sand. Gotcha. 11-11-8. And let's see. The phony tip came from some competitors who were hoping to harm the car dealership's reputation. Alright, unfortunately everybody's kind of tied up right now. Let's see. Just as I thought, Boyd, we'd make a great team with my resources and your abilities. We could work wonders together. I'll be glad to provide you with any services I can for a modest fee. It's the least I can do. Nice, 12,000, hell yeah. Let's end the day. The one that could see everything. I don't remember that one. Is that the one that had the ice stalks going like that? This game's pretty sweet, I gotta say. Although, I will preface, like, with saying this game's got some heavy topics in it. So, like, it's one of those games where, like, if you talked about this game with someone you knew, like, on a park bench in public, and someone walked by, you could possibly offend someone so much that they might want to hurt you. Like, that's how heavy the topics in this game gets. So just, you know, keep it in the game, right? That's what I like to do. I'll be a corrupt police officer in this game and, like, try to, like, not bring it up too much in real life, because there's some heavy topics in this game. But yeah, let's go ahead and it's time to switch over to Morrowind. So if you guys were here for This is the Police, I hope you enjoyed. We'll be back tomorrow for more This is the Police, but if you'd like, I'm playing Morrowind next. It's pretty much my, like, usual thing, so just stay tuned, and I'll be back in just a few seconds with Morrowind. I just gotta switch a few things over, and I will see you guys in a little bit.